You said that that language was racist and hateful. Do you still believe that today?
Well, I'm actually glad you asked that because for about the first 4 weeks of the election, I was watching CNN and I was naively believing some of the headlines that I saw on CNN. And
headlines, that's fine. I just want to know if you also personally
still believe that. I'm actually not going to read the headlines. So I very quickly came around and supported the president. In fact, CNN hired me. I was on many 8-on-1 panels where I proudly supported this president, who I believe is one of the best presidents, if not the best president this country will ever have. But I would encourage the individual who did that analysis of my past, rather than focusing on me, he really should be focused on some of the very guests CNN chose to have on their network. He should be focused on, I mean, my over here, Jim Clapper, who said, you know, 10 days before he privately told investigators there was no evidence of collusion, that Watergate pales in comparison to the Russia probe. I'd encourage them to look at Samantha Powers, who's privately saying, I'm not in possession of any evidence of collusion. Ambassador Rice, I don't recall intelligence or evidence of any collusion. Former Attorney General Loretta Lynch, I do not recall that being briefed to me. And for 3 years, 2 years, probably more than that, CNN ran with the collusion narrative. And if the American people are watching right now, you're probably very confused as to some of the quotes I read, because those individuals were saying much different things publicly than they were saying privately. And I'm very grateful that those transcripts were released yesterday. And perhaps the K-File should do an analysis of that. Yes, Emily?
Are you walking back those comments today at all? Or do you stand by those comments that you made?
I support this president. There is no questioning that. So honored to work for him. And Ebony, next question.
Thank you.